All right, good morning, everybody, and welcome to this, well, what we used to call yin yoga. It's a gentle yoga practice recorded, so it's going to be available on YouTube for you guys if you ever want to go back to it. And if you've subscribed to my YouTube channel, you will get a notification every time I put something up. So just a nice reminder that some of those are there. All right, let's just come to our mats and just take a moment. We've got a very snowy day out there. So I think it's actually kind of helping us start the day off on a more relaxed, peaceful foot. Close down the eyes, okay? And just take a moment to root down into your mat and notice the connection with the earth. I'm gonna have you take your big thumb to your index finger and point the palms up. Maybe your legs are crossed, or maybe they're one in front of the other, whatever feels comfortable to you right now. Just take a nice, nice deep breath in through the nose and feel it as it enters in through the chest. Pulling it deep into the stomach and then exhaling through the mouth. Let's repeat that for a few more rounds. And then bring your breath to your nose and out through the nose. And notice the body relaxing into the mat. Feeling all that surrounds you right now and that's holding you. We're coming to the middle of March, or middle of February, sorry. March is going to be showing up a lot of energy, so take advantage of the peacefulness of February right now, these last couple of weeks, because in March, the cosmos will be shaking things up quite a bit, because there's a lot of movement in planets. But in February, we're in a place where we just have an opportunity to really look at all the changes that have taken place over the last year. We're moving into the astrological new year. There's been a lot of hurdles over the past couple of years, but especially in this last year. So take note what those hurdles were. Take note how you overcame them, if you overcame them. And show some gratitude for the strength that has come out of this. Take a moment to create an intention for your practice today, tomorrow, and for the week. With your eyes still closed, bring your hands together in prayer. And imagine a little pressure between the palms and aligning both hemispheres of the brain in unison with this pressure. Thinking about the heart space today. Just allowing ourselves to fill our heart up with all the love that we have. And as we feel it, the heart expands, imagining that love filtering out into everything we do, everyone we interact with, everything we touch today. Just deep breath in. And as you exhale, slowly start to open the eyes, reach the arms all the way up towards the sky, looking up towards the universe. And as you exhale, dropping the hands down, interlacing the fingers behind the back and opening up the chest and heart center, allowing the shoulders to just roll off the chest. And then taking the hands and bringing them up, fingertips behind the head. As you exhale, allowing the elbows to drop back behind the body, giving a little lift to that heart center.
And then taking the arms around the front of the body, interlacing the fingers, rounding the upper back. Hold. And then bringing the hands to the floor, we're going to turn ourselves sideways and grab our yoga blocks. If you don't have yoga blocks, you can always use a pillow at home. And this is a heart opener. Since we're talking about heart today, this is going to go below the shoulders, and this is here to support the head. This is below the shoulder blades or on them. It just depends on your back and where you feel comfortable. Okay. So. Place your feet back flat on the floor, hands to the shins, and just slowly start to roll back and feel the yoga block on the back. And then allow your head to relax down. I actually got this in one first try, so I don't have to move my yoga blocks around. But if you feel like there's a weird pressure in the back or something just doesn't feel right, playing around with the yoga block, it usually has to go below the shoulder blades. And close down the eyes, and let's bring the hands again so that the palms are facing up. Take a nice deep breath in. And as you exhale, allow the body to drape onto the blocks, imagining there's no bones in the body. Allowing the heart center to open up as the shoulders pull slightly on that chest to create a bigger opening. Take a moment to scan the face. Maybe relaxing the eyebrows. Relaxing the cheekbones. Maybe unpursing the lips. Dropping the tongue from the roof of the mouth. Noticing if the shoulders are too close to the ears, we want to relax them.
You can straighten your legs out and allow the toes to turn out to the side.
Taking a couple more breaths right here, everybody. Just deepening the breath and bringing the body back to awareness. Bring the feet together, reach the arms up over the head. Bring the biceps to the ears. Take a nice inhale, and as you exhale, take the arms around the body, engage the core, and roll up and over the legs. Just opening up that upper back. It might feel a little stiff after that this morning. Inhale, very slowly bring that right foot into that left thigh. And as you exhale, reach for the outside of that left leg. Pull. Inhale, roll back up, everybody. And if the knee is okay on the right, you want to reach the hand down and lift up onto that knee, flowing beautifully as you reach through the fingertips, lift the hip up towards the sky. Pushing through that right arm, pushing the leg away, drop your bicep to your ear and lengthen through the side of the body, bicep to the ear. Reach the arm long. Yeah, there you go. Hold. Inhale, come back down. Beautiful, everybody. Reach over one more time. Roll up slowly, switch the legs. We'll extend the right leg. Left foot comes into the right thigh. Reach all the way down and over the leg for the outside of the leg, dropping the chin to the chest. Now, if you're like me right now, you might feel that your back is really tight around your armpit. It's just a reflection of my workout yesterday. Inhale, come up. Reach that left hand behind the body. Lift up onto the left knee. Reach the arm up and over the body. Open the shoulders slightly and just feel that line of pull all the way from the fingertips to the toes. Inhale, come back down. One more time, reach over that leg. Really reach into the outside ankle. And then rolling up very gently. So we're gonna need your bolster for this next one. And so we're gonna keep our feet, soles of the feet together in butterfly, okay? And we can place the bolster on the feet. You don't have to be too close. Your feet towards your body, okay? And I want you to lean forward, placing your forehead on the bolster, okay? And if you've got yoga blocks and you want to place your hands on the yoga blocks, you're welcome to do that, just place them on the side, okay? Take a nice deep breath in, and as you exhale, you can place your hands down on the yoga blocks. And just feel a very gentle opening in the low back, okay? And another thought is if you're feeling a little strain in the inner thigh, you can place the yoga blocks underneath your knees. And just hold it here. We'll be here for another minute and a half. We'll try and relax the body, maybe scan it and see if you're holding tension anywhere. I just caught myself. It's tensing up my legs. We'll be here for another 10 breaths. Start to inhale deeply through the nose, pulling the breath deep down into the belly, holding it for a count of 4, 3, 2, 1, and exhale through the mouth, nice cleansing, audible breath. Two more times, inhale, hold, and exhale. Inhale. And exhale. All right, take hold of your bolster, everybody. Place it to the side. Extend the legs all the way out. And now we're going to do the opposite of what we were just doing. Place the hands behind you. And as you exhale, lift up. Okay, look straight up, don't drop the neck. Notice the shoulders opening, squeeze the glutes and tighten up the belly. Exhale down, beautiful. One more time, reach over with another asana here. Seated forward fold, pushing the tenasana. Lift up nice and slowly, sliding the legs in, okay? And you can place them right here. Hands are behind your back, okay? Lifting the legs up. Now, if this is too much, you can just do one at a time, okay, to you. Holding it right here. Reaching the arms forward. Again, if you're not advanced, you can do this. Okay. Holding it right here. Abs tight, chest up. Nice. Challenging that ab area. Slowly coming down if it's in your practice today. And the body will speak very clearly and loudly if it's something you want to do. Being careful that low back, or pulling the belly button in. Slowly coming down, holding it. Abs are tight. And listen, if you can't come down any further, that's fine. Stay exactly where you're at. The body feels good. Maybe a little lower. A little lower. All the way down to the floor. Beautiful, everybody. You'll need your yoga block for this next hip stretch. We're going to place the yoga block out to the side in alignment with the hip. When you're ready, take that left, now this is my left leg, okay? Maybe at home you're on your right. Whatever you want to do, just make sure you make the adjustment, okay? Extend the leg up. Actually, you know what? Start with the bent knee. Come all the way out. And then extend it onto the yoga block. So it meets the yoga block, okay? And then cactus the arms, okay? Hold it right here. Another option is to place the right arm on that left leg and hold it right there, okay? So that yoga block is supporting that leg. Now, if it feels like it's too hard, you can always add a yoga block, okay? Make the leg a little higher, taking the stress out of the hip, okay? Either way is fine, okay? Left arm is cactus,
And I've got my right hand on my leg, but again, using both arms to cactus is an awesome option. We'll be here for another 10 breaths. Three more breaths, everybody. And when you're ready, I'd like to take my right hand, lift that left leg as you bend it and pull it into the body, rolling onto your back. Give it a nice little hug. Hold it right here for a moment. Yeah. Slide the right leg in, place the left ankle on the right thigh, and reach from behind the leg or on the shin. It just depends on your flexibility. You want to feel a stretch in the left hip. That's our target. Try not to lean into the left, keeping that right knee in alignment with that right shoulder. Really gets a better stretch in the hip. Relax the upper body. And then relax the legs down. Beautiful, everybody. So we're going to switch over to the other side. We've got a lot of room, so I'm going to move over a little bit here. Take that yoga block out to the side. Maybe line it up with the hip or a little below the hip. It just, the higher it is and the closer the hip, it is more difficult to stretch. So pull the leg all the way in. Yeah. Take a moment to let it relax. And then as you twist, you lengthen the leg, place it on the yoga block. And again, if you need two yoga blocks, if this is too hard, double up the yoga blocks, which I'm gonna do because my hips aren't tight. There. And I've got my left hand on my right thigh. My right arm is in a cactus position. You can also go on your waist if that feels better. Close down the eyes. We'll be here for 10 breaths. Another three breaths. Beautiful, everybody. Use that left hand to help lift the right leg as you roll onto your back. Pull the knee into the chest. Slide the left leg up, brace the right ankle on the left leg. Reach through, grabbing that leg wherever you grabbed it on the other side. Pull. Nice, everybody. Reach up to the sky with those toes. Point and flex. Reach for the outside of the feet, pulling the knees gently towards the armpits, rocking back and forth. Allowing for that inner thigh stretch. Pulling the soles of the feet together, take a nice deep breath in, reaching the forehead up to the toes. And exhaling down. One more time, everybody. Inhale all the way up. And exhale down. Beautiful. Reach the legs out, arms out. Advanced people, don't touch the floor. Not so advanced, please feel free to bring your feet and arms to the ground. Grab onto those knees, create a beautiful little ball with the body. And then holding the legs from behind the thigh, nice little rock back and forth, massaging the spine and pulling yourself back up to a seated position. And turn and face me. Placing your feet back into that position of Supasana. Closing down the eyes, but putting the hands right in front of the heart center as we close down this practice. Thank you guys for making it here in the snowstorm we're having. So nice to see people walk through the door. And take a nice deep breath in and settle in, knowing that the peacefulness of the snow and nature easily translated into us, every cell of the body, because we are so part of nature. And there's this illusion that we're separate, but we're not. We're all composed of the five elements, just different amounts. Take a nice inhale, everybody. And as you exhale, join me in stilling the practice. Namaste.
Namaste.
Have a wonderful day, everyone here, everyone at home. Thanks for joining me, and I will see you next time.